Next topic, Kasker stages or multi-stage amplifier. So Kasker stage is nothing but more than one stages is connected in a series manner. It is called as Kasker stage. If the voltage or power gain obtained from a single stage small signal amplifier is not sufficient for practical applications. So the why we go for Kasker means single stage small signal amplifier, we are not getting a sufficient amount of voltage or power. When we connect a more than one single stage means it will better to get a high voltage power as well as current gain. So that's why we go for cascaded amplifier. So more than one stages of amplification is used to achieve necessary voltage and power gain. Such an amplifier is called as multi-stage amplifier. In multi-stage amplifier, the output of one stage is fed as the input to the next stage. So multi-stage amplifier is the one stage is the output of first stage is fed to the input of second stage. That is called as the cascade stage or multi-stage. So in this multi-stage, the voltage gain is calculated as output voltage divided by input voltage. That is V02 divided by VI1. So from that we can Using the voltage gain for second stage and the voltage gain for first stage. In second stage, the output is V02, input is VI2. And first stage, the output is V01, input is VI1. So these two cancel. So the overall voltage is V0 by VI. If AV equal to V02, VI2 into V01, VI1, that is AV equal to AV2 into AV1. A multi-stage amplifier using two or more single-stage common emitter amplifier is called as cascaded amplifier. So cascade stage means more than one stage. Cascade amplifier means two or more single stages of common emitter amplifier. If the common emitter amplifier is connected in a cascade means it is called as a cascade amplifier. But in Torlington amplifier we can use the two common collector amplifier. So if we using a more number of common collector amplifier, then it is a Torlington amplifier. If we using a two or more than common collector amplifier, then it is a cascade amplifier. So before seeing cascade amplifier, first we know what is meant by coupling. Coupling is nothing but we connect the more number of stages. That is called as coupling. So there are different types of coupling is there. So when amplifiers are cascaded, it is essential to using a coupling network between the output of one stage to the input of next stage. The coupling networks provided the two purpose. The purpose of coupling network is transfer the AC output of one stage to the input of next stage. That is, it directly transfer the AC to AC from one stage first stage to second stage. And second point is it isolates the DC condition of one stage to next stage. For DC analysis, it isolates from one stage to next stage, but in AC it will transfer from one stage to next stage. So the types of couplings are RC coupling, that is resistance capacitance coupling, transformer coupling, direct coupling. Let's see one by one. So resistance capacitance coupling, so this is the diagram of resistor capacitor coupling. That is, this is one stage, this is one stage, right? So these two stages are connected with the help of RC coupling. So here we are using a capacitor, that is RC coupling. It is the most commonly used coupling. It is not expensive and has satisfactory frequency response. The signal developed across the RC of each stage is coupled to the CC into the base of next stage. That is, the signal developed across the RC. When the collector resistance, when what are this energy or power or voltage or current which developed across this resistance is directly coupled to the base of the next stage through this capacitor, through this coupling. So the coupling capacitor isolates the DC conditions of one stage from the following stage. The amplifier using this coupling methods are called the RC coupled amplifier. Next one is transformer coupling. So here one stage is connected to another stage with the help of transformer. That is called transformer coupling. The primary winding of the transformer acts as a collector load, which act as a collector RC, and the secondary winding transformer, the AC output signal directly to the base of the next stage. That is, the primary transformer act as a collector if anything developed across this collector is directly transferred through this secondary transformer into the base, so which is called as the transformer coupling. And third one is direct coupling. So direct coupling, there is no component between this connection, which directly connected from output of one stage to the input of next stage. So the AC output signal is fed directly to the next stage. No reactance is included in the coupling network. No reactance means maybe a capacitor or transformer, anything. It is used when amplification of low frequency signal is to be done. So in that purpose we are using a direct coupling. So next one, cascade amplifier. That is two stage RC coupled common emitter and common base cascaded amplifier. So in this cascade amplifier we are connecting a two stages. The two stages is common emitter amplifier and common base amplifier, which is connected with the help of direct RC coupling, right? RC coupling. So cascade amplifier is a composite amplifier pair with a large bandwidth used for RF applications and a video amplifier. So the purpose of cascade amplifier is it produces a large bandwidth. It can be used in a RF amplification and video amplifier. It consists of common emitter stage amplifier, which is followed by common base stage amplifier with the direct RC coupled to each other. It gives the input impedance and current gain that of common emitter amplifier, and the voltage gain that of common base amplifier, good isolation between the input and output. So in cascade amplifier we are using a two amplifier stages. One is common emitter, another one is common base. Common emitter amplifier give a input impedance and current gain, so which is very high when compared to common base. So the voltage gain that of common base, good isolation between the input output. In common base the voltage gain become a high when compared to common emitter. So this is the circuit diagram of cascaded amplifier. This part is common emitter amplifier. The output of common emitter is collected terminal, so which is connected to the input of the common base. In common base the input is emitter terminal and common terminal is base. So here we are using a direct coupling, right? So this is the circuit diagram of cascade amplifier. This is the equivalent H parameter diagram of the above one. So from that circuit we can find out the current gain, voltage gain, input resistance and output resistance. So for second stage AI2 output divided by input, so the value is HFE by 1 plus HFE. Similarly RI2 AV voltage gain. So likewise first stage we are finding AI RI, then voltage gain multiplying both AV1 AV2, then overall resistance RI is RI1 parallel RP. Then when on the account of source resistance we can find AVS and AAS, finally output resistance. So in a second unit the derivation part is more or less same, that is we are going to find input resistance, output resistance, voltage gain, current gain. We know the formula for each factor, each parameter. Already we discussed in a H parameter model, that is H11, H22, H12, H21. Output current divided by input current, output voltage divided by input voltage. Likewise, we known all the parameters formula. So by using that formula, applying KVL or KCL, we can find out individual parameter. So that's all about the cascade amplifier. So from this, we completed the unit 2.